Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the MTFM radio show. I'm your host, Mouse. Sit back, relax. The show will begin shortly. Thank you so much for tuning in this evening. You're listening to MTFM. Tonight I wanted to talk about music. Music's a very interesting thing to me. It reminds me of certain emotions, certain feelings of different times. Music is also quite a powerful thing. I know through music you can tell stories and all sorts of bits and pieces like that. So I wanted to share with you guys a few songs that really mean something to me. That really bring out a story or a feeling or a memory within me. So I've got two songs here for you this evening. First one comes from Mac DeMarco. Now, Mac DeMarco is a Canadian singer-songwriter. Some people know him as the Prince of Indie. He's an absolute goofball on stage. I've seen him. He's an absolute character. Loved going to his concerts. So we're hearing one of his songs, My Kind of Woman, from him. And another one, a little bit different to that, Kings of Leon, Be Somebody. You're listening to MTFM.
Really no fuss.
You're listening to MTFM. On last week's show, we asked you to for you to phone in. We've got one of our listeners here this evening, Zach. How are you, Zach?
Hey, Mouse, big fan of the show.
Glad to hear it, glad to hear it. So, last week we asked you guys, our dear listeners, as 2021 comes to an end, what has been the biggest waste of time? So, Zach, in your opinion, what has been the biggest waste of time of 2021?
I think that ship that got trapped in the Suez Canal, that wasted pretty much everyone's time for a good week or so. Yeah, that was pretty stink.
Yes, no, that was a pretty... It was very interesting to sit back and observe, I would say. Very, very interesting. A little bit off topic. You know, as both 2020 and 2021 have been a very challenging years for people, especially with the introduction of coronavirus and everything going around with that. Looking forward, how do you see coronavirus affecting day-to-day life?
I feel like most people imagine it'll affect day-to-day life less and less. I don't necessarily agree with that. I think for a long while yet, it'll still continue to be just as big of a part in everyone's lives, but I think in different forms, and we're already starting to see that, we have to act in different ways with the new curveballs that it keeps throwing us. But that's just part of it, learning to adapt, I guess.
Yeah, no, most definitely. Okay, looking back at 2021, what do you think was, like, what part of 2021 do you think that people are going to remember? You know, if you were to create a YouTube rewind of 2021 for all of Aotearoa, what would you put into that rewind?
I would put Chris Hipkins saying spread your legs.
Yes, that was pretty memorable. I'm gonna be honest there, that was pretty memorable. What else has been been good about this year?
What's been good about this year? Not a lot, but I can say personally it's been pretty good. I know I've had a lot more creative outlets this year. I think personally that's something I'll look back on very fondly. So if I was doing a personal rewind, it would be more about that.
Yes, wonderful. Hey look, Zach, thank you so much. We'll continue this one a little bit later on. Up next is Puma Blue, Untitled 2. You are listening to MTFM.
Express this love, cut a dove. That I can't release, insist to feel. Express this love, cut a dove. That I can't release until I cease to feel.
Thanks for tuning in with us tonight. Remember, for all those other listeners, if you want a chance to come on MTFM, make sure you let us know. Get in contact with us. You can find us on YouTube. You can send us an email or write us a letter. We will make sure you're subscribed to the newsletter. We will be coming up with next week's question. Have a long think about that one. We'll select you and we'll bring you on the air. And it'll be a great time. Up next, two of my favourite songs from my personal collection. I hope you guys enjoy. You're listening to MTFM.
Thank you.
Just before we were listening to Mama Don't Tell Me and followed by Little Lies, I want to talk about cryptocurrency. It's a very interesting topic, I feel like. It's quite a bizarre thing, having money, but it's not physical money. I mean, yeah, I guess you can talk about that the money in your bank account isn't physical, but I mean, you can walk down to your ATM and withdraw, that sort of thing. Well, with cryptocurrency, it's quite a new thing, and I find it quite fascinating. I don't know how it's going to play alongside currently what we have now. Will there be whole countries and whole governments just run by this whole cryptocurrency? I don't know. I find it quite fascinating. I mean, when I was reading an article quite a few weeks back now, but there's a country overseas, name forgets me, but they're now accepting cryptocurrency as legal tender. And I thought that was fascinating. And you know, you have Elon Musk with Tesla and his whole cryptocurrency thing. So I think there is potential. It's Are we ready yet? I don't think so. I mean, yes, it's all early days. Cryptocurrency only really boomed in about 2014, around that whole time. And it's only gone up from there. And it's gone to the point now where I can walk down to my grandparents' place and they're talking about cryptocurrency. So people know what kind of what it is. They've got the name in their head, but they don't fully understand it. I had to go down and try and explain cryptocurrency to my grandparents the other day. I found that kind of interesting. Which also kind of brings me to my second point here. I want to talk about how things are going on in the world. You know, when we think of things at the moment, it's all becoming automated, and you know, jobs are going to get taken over by robots and all sorts and bits and pieces like that. And I think that's quite interesting, because you know, at the end of the day, a robot isn't going to program itself. It ain't going to plug itself in. We're the ones that have to go plug it in. So I think that yes, automation is going to take away a fair bit. I think of all the accountants and all of that sort of stuff. Now it's just online. You know, you go on and you use a service like Wave or a service like Xerox or something like that, and that takes care of everything for you, which is wonderful. But however, it makes traditional accountants redundant. And it's not just accountants. For, you know, you've got a lot of people think that the IT field is indestructible. You know, you've got IT is just climbing. So much is going on. So many things are happening. And people just think that it's never going to crash. But the reality of that as well is that yes, it's a growing industry, but it's also getting taken over by computers, which I find kind of amusing. It's very interesting to see how things are playing out, and with all, you know, times are changing. You know, we've gotten to the point now where a lot of businesses have said, no, stay at home, work at home. It's a lot easier for us, and it's a lot cheaper for us. We don't have to pay building maintenance fees. We don't have to pay the electricity at that particular office. So a lot of people are just residing to staying home. So there's that whole change as well. You know, our lives are online. Everything that we do is online. There's no way of really escaping that, which I find quite interesting. We'll talk more about this after the break. Up next is Fast Car by Tracy Chapman.
What I do. enough so we can fly away. We gotta make a decision. Leave tonight or live and die this way. So I remember when we were driving, driving in your car. Speed so fast, I feel like I was drunk. City lights, day out the boys, and your arms felt nice wrapped around my shoulder. And I had a feeling that I belonged. I had a feeling I could be someone, be someone, be someone. Cruise and entertain ourselves. Still ain't got a job. Now work in the market as a checkout girl. I know things will get better. You'll find work and I'll get promoted. And we'll move out of the shelter. Buy a bigger house and live in the suburb. So I remember when we were driving, driving in your car. Speed so fast, felt like I was drunk. City lights.
I've just been informed that our dear listener, Michael, it's your birthday today, buddy. Happy birthday. Happy, happy birthday. Big 18th. Man, I hope you have a wonderful, wonderful day and that you get spoiled, because boy, can I tell you, you definitely deserve it. Out of everyone that I know, you are more deserving of a beautiful birthday. I can tell you that right now. You are such an amazing friend. So I hope you have a wonderful, wonderful day today. Anyway, up next is Avondale Bowling Club with Trainwreck Mount Roskill here on MTFM. Thank you. You are listening to MTFM. Hey, thank you guys so much for listening in this evening. A little bit in continuation to what we were talking about before, in terms of, you know, the big changes in today's world, I wanted to talk about almost in comparison to previous years, you know, looking back at the good old days, as people like to say. I think it's quite interesting, you know, because I wouldn't want to go back. I know some people would. I wouldn't. I feel like the world that we live in now is good. You know, it's got pretty much everything that one needs. You look back and a lot of what we have now and a lot of what we take for granted just simply wasn't there. A lot of the creature comforts. And I guess some people like that. The fact that there isn't those creature comforts of what we have today. And it's a bit of a challenge. It's a bit of a challenge for some people. I don't know. I have people come up to me and go, you know, things were just better back in the good old days. You know, they don't get built the same way. And it's like, yes, I'm aware of that. And, you know, we have all these problems now with, you know, global warming and all sorts of bits and pieces, you know. We're running out of this thing, or this thing has happened, and so on and so forth. I think with all those shortcomings of today, you know, we are more aware of what is happening. You know, when we think, like, take for example the medical sector, you know, way back, and, you know, this is going quite far, you know, if you got a cut or anything like that, or, you know, if something was, you know, if something happened, it was usually just alcohol and a cigarette, you know, send you on your way sort of thing. But when we look at things now, in the medical field, there's so much, we know so much more, and we can treat things so much better. So that whole evolution is really amazing, I think. And I think the world that we live in today is wonderful. Yes, it has its shortcomings. Yes, it has its faults. Yes, it has this. Yes, it has that. But I think with all of its quirks and features, sound like a Doug DeMuro video, all of its quirks and features, I think the world that we live in now is wonderful. I don't know. That's just my opinion. Anyway, here's Kings of Leon with 17. You are listening to MTFM.
Thank you.
You were listening to MTFM. Thanks for joining us this evening. Just before, we were talking about things of today in contrast to previous years. Now, I was talking about people going, you know, I was talking about people going on and saying how, oh, I want to go back and all of this and all that sort of thing. One of the main reasons for someone saying this is probably their comfort zone. And I want to talk a little bit more about comfort zones. I feel like people's comfort zones are very, very interesting. You know, you have your comfort zone and you feel comfortable inside that comfort zone. But I also think it's beneficial for someone to extend out of that comfort zone, to broaden, to expand on their comfort zone. And I think the only way of us doing that is looking at, you know, looking at what do we fear and how can we expand on such a thing. And I feel like people get stuck inside their comfort zones and they're a bit scared to push themselves and to extend it. Anyway, that's going to be a question for next week's episode. Make sure you get in contact with us regarding that. You're listening to MTFM.
It always ends up to one thing, honey, when I look and you're not there. I need to know you, need to feel my arms around you. Feel my arms around you, like sea around the shore. Each night and day I pray and hope that I might find you, and hope that I might find you, because hearts can do no more. Do it always ends up to one thing, honey. Still I kneel upon the floor.
Yet again, thank you for tuning in to MTFM. Now, we had music from Cat Stevens, followed by... what was that song? That's a great question. My apologies. How Can I Tell You by Cat Stevens. We had Little Bit and YKWIM. Now it's time for the weather. Here in the capital, it's been a pretty miserable day, let's be honest. Not the best, but that's okay. We had a high of 20 and a low of 15. The outlook for this week follows: Wednesday, partly cloudy with a high of 19 and a low of 14. Thursday, mostly sunny, high of 21 and a low of 14. Friday, high of 21, low of 14, partly cloudy. Saturday, mostly sunny, high of 22. Sunday, mostly sunny and a high of 23. You are tuned into MTFM. This is Orlando Blood Orange.
That we often put onto a lot of folk is like, oh, you're doing too much. And so, like, a couple years ago, I was like, you know what, my resolution, my eternal resolution will be to do too much.
Yes. I love it.
Thank you so much for tuning in to MTFM this evening. It's been an absolute pleasure to have you on the airwaves. Huge shout out to our listeners. Michael, man, happy birthday. I hope you've had a wonderful, wonderful day. Man, Michael is a great friend of ours and a dear listener, so thank you. Anyway, until next time, ka kite. Stay safe, be kind, enjoy your evening. Thank you.
la imaginación. Cuando el tiempo se detiene y todo lo que tienes es tu más profunda compañía. Cuando el peso de la gravedad consuela tus miembros cansados y el sol completa su abrupto descenso. Cuando tu cuerpo murmura con profunda sensación de paz y el eco del tambor sonoro resuena en tus oídos, engranando los cimientos de tu respuesta al lastre de tu semana, y quedas inmóvil. Al fin, donde la luz traspasa la percepción y las ondas sonoras se vuelven letárgicas mientras tu reflejo parece más vivo. Donde la disonancia de la desesperación disminuye lentamente y la garra de la bestia que sostiene tu éxtasis se debilita. Donde la seda es rugosa e incluso la roca más áspera se transforma en piedra pulida. Donde se diluye la presencia de tu posición y ni ya no eres más consciente de la cama en donde yaces. Hay una tentación de resistir, pero a medida que te adentras en el laberinto, ríndete y deja que tu intuición navegue. Mirar hacia atrás no siempre es inútil. Los frutos de viajes previos proveen la base necesaria para continuar tu historia. Si pudieras conocer a tu yo más joven, ¿qué revelaría? ¿Tu genio se ha mantenido fiel a su arquetipo? ¿O el veneno del mundo goteó en tu madurez sin dejar migas para encontrar su hogar? Tu fortaleza para aferrarte a la juventud es una devoción digna de tiempos inmemoriales. Puede que ya no sea juvenil soñar con la inmortalidad, mientras todas tus fantasías siguen siendo posibles. Deja que el niño que llevas dentro libere tus ideas limitadas y ábrete a desconocidas. Tu cuerpo ya no es el vehículo, donde el color existe en multitud de prismas y las oscilaciones del tiempo rebotan entre felicidad y duelo. El sueño te ha otorgado una clave extraordinaria. Desenterrando recuerdos perdidos o concibiendo nuevos, tu mente adquiere forma expansiva. Una meditación abstracta sobre la esencia compleja del ser, explorando objetos de conciencia refugiados en tu dormitar. A medida que despiertas lentamente, la complejidad de tus experiencias únicas dejan residuos emocionales en su naturaleza fundamental, ya que el proceso catártico de la imaginación sigue siendo vital. Entonces, después de haber retenido esa compañía profunda, después que la gravedad levantase su peso de tu pecho y tus extremidades relajadas agitaran sombras en la puesta,